After the launch, Professor Mace will track and record for the Evening Star.
Won't we need some special high-frequency equipment?
Your remote control unit will be put aboard the Starduster tonight. You will blast off at 0600 hours.
Oh, dear.
The cry of a disappointed female. What is it, Crystal?
I was hoping to have my hair done. It's been days.
I guess some things never change.
Watch my mouth as I talk. Isn't that swell? I'll show you how it's done.
After the sketches are colored in, we move on to animation. Voice actors are filmed wearing makeup that emphasizes their lips and matches their skin color to the painted cells. The footage is then rushed off to the effects department. There, the effects wizards mask out the unwanted portions of the film and superimpose the full motion talking lips onto the face. Ah, that's better. Cambria had a tight budget back then, and they got very creative. Certain effects were handled using real props instead of animated sequences.
Yeah!
An old feather pillow does the trick. Where'd that fan go?
Going away. Grab him, Gizzard.
I am, Foxy. I got two. Get him. Get him. Look out, Gizzard. You're going to fall. Look out for the mud.
There was no animation below the waists when characters walked. That saved a lot of time.
Fire! Help! Fire! Fire!
Take him! He's on fire!
Fire is pretty complicated to draw, but we have a fireplace. Take that camera home and get to work. Watch out for the elephant.
Let me help you.
Take it easy, Jumbo.
Anyone got a cigarette? Blow some smoke in front of the camera for me, will ya?
Goodbye, man. And thank you.
What's wrong, Clutch?
I don't know. Started okay yesterday.
Hey, Clutch! Hurry! That other plane is taking off already!
In this scene, Bubblegum gets stuck in the jet's tailpipe. Solution? Film an inflating balloon and rotate 90 degrees.
Look! Something's bugging out the tailpipe!
Bubblegum!
Bubblegum? Someone tried to gum up the valves!
Stand back! Hang on, Spinner. That thing will blast us off any second.
Put on your oxygen masks. This is gonna be a zero launch.
What a takeoff! Good luck, boys!
Cargo with his pals Spinner and Paddlefoot in another exciting adventure, Kangaroo Express.
Australia, the land of kangaroos and bushmen, the magic land of seaports and deserts, the land down under. Through this desert and bush country, huffing and puffing and straining every valve, travels a little Australian choo-choo. Inside the tiny passenger car rides Clutch Cargo and Company.
And so the reason for our trip to Australia is to find the plane that was forced to land in this territory.
We're at this point now. The railroad goes northeast to a point near where Jim Jim Creek and the Coolatong River meet.
Then 35 miles directly west of this point is where we'll find the plane.
Was the plane on a mission?
Yes, very important one. The plane is loaded with treasure, Australian diamonds, thousands of them.
What about the pilot? Is he there?
No. He made his way through the bush country to a small place known as Clon Curry, an airfield used during the war.
As far as I know, Spinner, we're the only ones who know about the plane. It's our job to bring back the treasure, and we must be careful.
Did you hear that talk? That's Clutch Cargo and his pals, all right, and that's the map.
That means we've got to think of some way to get our hands on the map. Right, Bad?
Right. Just keep your eyes open. We'll find a chance.
I put the map safely in my pocket. And remember, mum's the word.
Oh, I won't say a word to anyone.
I'm going to get a drink of water. I'll be right back.
Now's our chance. Come on.
What's that?
Oh, pardon me, sir. The train must have jerked just then. Very sorry.
Well, okay, but please be more careful.
Oh, we will, won't we all?
That we will. Come on, Paddington.
Oh, well, maybe I shouldn't have been so abrupt.
Did you get the map?
Don't ask foolish questions. I'm in Ork, the best pickpocket in the business.
Good. Now to unhook this car for the rest of the drive. No sooner said than done, bad old boy.
Look, we're slowing down.
That's funny. No place way out here to stop. I'll take a look. No wonder we're stopping. Our car's been unhooked. And the map, it's gone.
They've gone, Clutch.
And we're stranded miles from the nearest settlement.
Boy, does the wind ever blow out here.
It's blowing the right way, too.
Huh? What do you mean?
You gave me an idea. I saw a big tarp and some line in the back of this car. Maybe that wind's strong enough.
Working swiftly with the huge tarpaulin and line, Clutch fashions a homemade sail.
Okay, Spinner. Let's hoist the sail and get underway.
Hey, we're moving!
We sure are, Spinner.
Boy, we're sure picking up speed. But how are we going to stop?
Here's our water stop. We'll pull off to the sergeant, Mac.
We'd better lower the sail, but quick.
But please, Stunt, what?
Brace yourself, Spinner. We're going to crash.
Oh, I can't look.
We're okay, Spinner. That train was on a siding.
But while Clutch and Spinner worked feverishly to take off the sail, they failed to see the warning sign for Dead Man's Curve. Can Clutch and Company avoid being crushed when they drop to the valley floor? Be sure to tune in for the next exciting episode with Clutch Cargo.
Exciting adventure in outer space with Scott McCloud, Space Angel.
Starduster, the Evening Star. I'm coming aboard.
Welcome home, Skipper. Take Landon 2-3.
Thanks, Doris. Starting approach.
How'd you make out, Skipper?
Just fine. Mission accomplished.
No problems?
No problems. Cutting rockets.
Drift down 2-5 degrees. Skipper, would you be sad you didn't miss me at all?
Down 2-5. Of course I missed you, you old space goat.
Well, now, that's better. Fire breaking rockets.
Rockets fired. Coming aboard.
Easy now. Easy. On target.
Eight ball in the corner pocket.
Well done, Skipper.
Thanks, Coach. See you topside.
Taurus, was that Scott?
Now, how would you be guessing that?
Woman's intuition. It never fails.
Eavesdropping, more likely. He'll be right up, Crystal.
Good. I just taped an urgent call from the chief.
Well, now, business must be picking up. And about time, too. I never was much for this sitting around.
That'll be the day.
And what might that mean?
It means you're lazier than a lizard on a warm rock.
What?
Scott, we didn't hear you. I'm awfully glad you're back. I missed you.
We missed you. And this new mission came up just in time.
What new mission?
Oh, we just got an urgent message from the chief. It's set up in the viewing room.
Let's go.
Following is a top secret briefing from the head of Earth Intelligence.
Scott, Project Solar Mirror is in trouble. I'm sending you over to Venus to straighten it out. Now, here's the background. All the planets in our solar system have gotten together to build this giant mirror. It reflects sunlight onto dead planets and makes them productive enough to grow food.
What a wonderful idea.
The mirror was built on Venus in three sections like this. A short time ago, a cargo ship left Venus to deliver the first section to its orbiting space station. It never showed up. The Space Force boys got right out there, but there wasn't a trace. We think it was hijacked. Caught in the wrong hands, the solar mirror could become the most powerful weapon in the universe. Now, here's what I want you to do. Go undercover and get that mirror back. Now, remember, Project Solar Mirror is a matter of life and death to millions of starving people. That's all. Good luck, Scott. Out.
Taurus, how'd you like to visit Venus?
Now you're talking, Skipper.
Set up the Starduster for immediate blastoff.
I'm halfway there, sir.
Crystal, where's Professor Mace?
Dad's in the research lab.
Ask him to take over the Evening Star till we get back, will you?
You mean, I can go too?
Of course. The chief wants that mirror back. And who can find a mirror faster than a pretty girl?
Scott McCloud.
target. Straight ahead.
Identify. Can you make it out yet, Joyce?
It could be a man in a spacesuit.
I'm firing braking rockets.
Now, what in the galaxy would...
I can see him. He's just drifting.
We'll take him aboard.
I don't like the looks of it. What if he's just bait?
But the hijacker's ready to spring a trap on us.
We've got to take that chance. That man's in trouble. Taurus, break out my space pack. I'm going out there.
I'll keep you covered with the ray beam, Skipper.
Right. Now remember, I'm out there, too. Close the lock.
Pressure equalized.
Open the outer panel. I'm on my way.
I don't like this. He's wide open out there.
He sure is, but I'll blast the first thing that moves. Scott's got him. They're on the way back.
Outer panel closed. Pressure equalized.
Torres, take the controls and head for Venus.
Yes, sir.
Chris, give me a hand with our friend here.
Don't miss the next exciting adventure with Torres, Crystal, and Scott McCloud. Space Captain Fathom. Rustlers of the Sea Range.
New control, this is Coast Guard 799er at 2300 hours. Condition normal and coast is clear. Over.
Niner, Niner. Roger.
What time is it?
6:30, Master.
It was daybreak an hour ago. She's long overdue.
She had to come a long way, Master.
Maybe she got hung up dodging patrol ships.
Our appointment was for daybreak. The mark of the reliable criminal is punctuality. The shark woman is...
Master, stand by, please.
Yes, I have a service craft and sonar, Master. Range 2 miles in direct bearing. An opposing fast. Master, we have a bogey vectoring in on my sonar pickup.
It looks like it's giving chase.
That could be the Coast Guard patrol ship, Master. He spotted the shark woman, and she's leading him straight here.
No, not really.
Bring your vessel to a full stop and prepare to receive us. This is your final warning.
We are authorized to fire upon you for failure to comply. Over.
Yes, Coast Guard. It is all over. For you.
August Zero, dispatch.
Blast them.
Our appointment was for daybreak, precisely. You were more than an hour late.
The master's obsession with punctuality is known by me, but I did not consider an error of 25,000 critical for this meeting.
Who is your most valued lieutenant?
He stands with me now, Ali Kazim.
You shall pay for your error in judgment with his life.
Master, do not do this. Not if you value me.
Your tone is threatening, my dear.
The shark woman owes allegiance to no one.
The shark woman preys upon the seven seas at the master's pleasure, if I so ordered.
With his pleasure or without it. Do not confuse convenience with necessity.
Very well, my dear. You shall retain your Ali Kazim. Now let us proceed to the purpose of our meeting.
Roger, Commander. What time was their last position report?
Roger. Argonaut out. Coast Guard patrol unreported since 0600. New heading, 105 true. All ahead, V-10. Put her on the step.
Roger.
Trachinotus carolinus iridaeus.
A rainbow pompino.
Precisely. A special cross-bred species of fish, currently valued in the medical world at $500 per pound.
This specimen is a 5-pound fish. It's worth $2,500.
The price will be much greater on the black market. There is a single source for these precious beauties. A breeding ground in the Gulf of Mexico. Command that source
and its immediate turnover value to us should exceed $5 million.
Your commission will be 25% if you'd care to undertake the mission.
The master wouldn't have called me here if he didn't already know the answer. I've never met a person who said no to the master a second time.
I know you shall succeed famously.